at city.com/ready.
Get the safety, privacy, and confidence of Avast 3D Protection. Live your best connected life. Avast. Download now.
The National Highway Traffic Safety Administration on ballot question one. The ballot initiative requires vehicle manufacturers to redesign their vehicles in a manner that necessarily introduces cybersecurity risks. A software vulnerability potentially being used by malicious actors to cause a crash or incident is the primary cybersecurity concern. This would raise substantial safety risks for American families. Read the entire statement yourself and vote no on one. Keep your data safe.
We'll be right back. Alright, you guys are live.
Alright.
Alright, here we are. Is this the final series or the second to last series?
This is the last series of the last play.
Yeah.
Alright, final series with Segmentation Fault versus 911. Their only game of the
right
season
away.
So far. Yeah, they've been watching a lot of Larkin's games. They know he's only good on Ezreal. I mean, what? they're banning out the Vel'Koz for Donor, for Donor. Is it Lux Deferral as a placement? I don't know. I have no idea.
I'm
you switch up people so
Zoe
many
too.
Times that I don't really, I don't know.
Yeah, these are smart bans from Seg. Both the Vel'Koz and the Zoe put in some work when
of course. Yeah, I was expecting the Akali third ban. They banned out two of Miguel's two of his major champions, but he has been practicing some new technology. So let's see if he's eager to put it out in the field today. Locked in MF, that's a donor specialty right there.
Yep. Again, puts in lots of work. So excited to see if Larkin picks an ADC or what they pick elsewhere on the map. I have no idea what you're supposed to do in this scenario. I'm just kind of throwing stuff out at this point.
I'm waiting for Larkin to pick his champ.
And he picks
Caitlyn. Alright. He's going for the rage.
Ooh, here we go. Here we go.
This might
Robert's
be a little
signature
spicy.
Volley bear. Let's go.
Alright, let's see if you can do the tower dives way more accurately this game.
Dude, I can't play volley bear for my life, but I'm excited to see Robert on this because he's put in work when I play with his volley bear. And like Simity takes the Shen.
This could be Shen top or Shen jungle. I'm
Shen
leaning
top, Shen
towards
top. Shen top.
Are you sure?
Yeah, like Simity, when we played against them, they wouldn't ban my Shen and steal, and they would take it first pick top lane.
We'll have to see.
But yeah, my big Stankmouse really like has a wide jungle pool, so I actually would not be shocked if I saw him jungling on Shen. In which case, I commend him because Shen is the way. But
like reverse Shen.
Dude, Shen jungle is actual technology though.
Well, I'm still waiting on the kneecap Nautilus play.
We're working on it.
I've never seen
if
the
other
Fabled
junglers
positive
have
play.
Have advice on Nautilus jungle. I'll be taking suggestions. Yeah. So
looks like they're putting Arlan on Braum. Okay.
Leona.
Braum and Caitlyn versus MF Leona.
So talk to me about
MF
this
out damages early.
Okay.
With the Leona hard CC, she's able to get on top of both people at once, so it's a little tough. I'd say it's honestly just a pure skill matchup, because Leona E can also be countered by the Caitlyn traps. It'll be hard for her to maneuver around traps and get the stuns in if Larkin's able to put them down in time.
No, that's true. Like,
Caitlyn does outrange MF, so that could also play a big factor. They banned out the Veigar and the Rengar.
Oh, really
four bans going
wow.
to Miguel.
Miguel's getting some attention.
Larkin be like, notice me, senpai.
Yeah, but he only gets the one ban. All right,
so is this the game Miguel finally
Virgin
picked
Larkin
the long away?
Ban versus Chad Miguel taking four bans away. The Ori game.
I was hoping this would finally break Miguel enough to make him pick Kayn mid.
Oh, I don't know. Orianna into... I'm thinking Shen's gonna try to build mostly tank. Let's see. If they pick two, assassins.
Fizz, okay.
Yeah, so it's an assassin mid lane.
And the Kayn
jungle,
the Kayn.
Okay.
Big Stankmouse is a man of culture. Man of culture right there. Yeah, I'm curious to see how this is going to go. From a Kayn's perspective, depends what formula really depends what Thomas picks here.
Renekt, and he might have to go full Red Kayn this game.
I'd go Red Kayn. There's a case to be made for going blue, even though there's only
well,
two
if he if he were to go blue, he'd have to go after the Ori and Caitlyn.
Well,
but
yeah, that's
with,
yeah.
with a front line like that, it'll be pretty tough to
exactly,
get to
but
to
like,
them.
I mean, even no matter what the hell happens, even if you're as long as you're blue cane and as long as they're caught out once, like, that's a delete button. But yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure Larkin's seen a lot of that delete.
Oh yeah, we just played a 2v2 ARAM again with him, and I was playing blue cane. I regret my decision, but I also don't, because that was freaking funny. please don't kill me, okay. Larkin. You know where I live. Anyway.
So I'm curious to see this Orianna versus Fizz matchup in the mid lane. I'm not entirely sure who wins that. Fizz has a lot of mobility to be able to get on top of Orianna and, you know, kind of like a hit and run kind of scenario where he gets on top, does his damage, and is able to get out possibly before Orianna is able to land her abilities. He automatically counters the Ori R because he's able to just use his jump to get out of it. If he lands his R on Orianna, there's not really much places that he can run to in order to stay safe. So I feel like this sense. It's up to Miguel to kind of outplay this. I'm in favor of the Fizz in this matchup.
I mean, I don't really know much about how either of them work, but I can definitely see it. Fizz has just mobility and more mobility.
Yeah, he's an assassin against the control mage. Like anything before 7-ish, level 7-ish, Fizz is going to be dominating it. Miguel's going to have to be very careful on how he's playing.
Well, I think level 1 and 2, Miguel is able to play a little bit further up, but I think after 3, he'll have to play super safe.
If he does have a level 2 tower dive cheese, he can pull off if he's really good. And we have seen Donor pull off some pretty fantastic stuff. Oh, there's Andrew.
I'm just happy I get to see both a Kane and a Shen in the same game.
Do you need a Discord stream? I should probably not be the one. Yeah, you start it.
Thank you.
Sir, I got Prime for a reason. Or what? Discord Nitro? Shit is called. Last quality.
Maybe it is just Discord Prime.
basically, just Discord Prime.
These chats should be actually...
We get the
Discord gets bought by Amazon.
We get the team insights by hearing Ardit's echo in the background.
I get the pro view from Arlen.
I'm gonna be hovering him the entire game, seeing these Leona plays.
Is Go Bills their sub? Their like replacement? Their sub?
Yeah, they have him as a sub.
You hug this wall.
Yeah, I'm
Buffalo Bills going undefeated, and we win in the Super Bowl.
Dude, I don't follow football, but my my friends from home are all in a fantasy football league with me.
Sure.
So like, I kind of just pick whatever like they say is the highest rated players, and apparently I have a good team. So we're chilling.
That's nice.
I still don't have any idea what the heck I'm doing with it though. I just click like this optimize button every week, and oh well.
I guess that works. I know the fantasy draft for League is supposed to come out next season, because this season it's being tested in China, if I remember.
Well, there's apps that do it, but they don't do it for Worlds. That's the thing. They only do it for the regular summer.
Yeah, the regular season. Yeah, I mean, League had its own fantasy draft thing, like you did online. I remember playing a couple
Pick'ems. Was it the Pick'ems you mean?
No, not the like Pick'ems.
No, Pick'ems happen all the time. Like every year, there's Pick'ems for Worlds. Which they didn't open the Pick'ems yet. I think they open it with the opening ceremony of Worlds, which is in like 2 days or so. Then they, I don't even think, do they do an opening ceremony for play-ins? Like they only started in groups, right?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So I'm pretty sure when groups starts or like a week before groups starts, they'll do the Pick'ems. All right, well, the skin game here, clearly won by Team Sega. Come on, Luxor, like, you need a Fizz skin, bro.
Hey, I know I've simped a lot for Shen and Kane, but both good skins from there too. I want that Psyop Shen skin,
like,
and I'm not gonna buy it till I get the Chroma.
I feel like they need to release another Kane skin.
Yes.
It's been a while.
When
was Odyssey, dude?
I don't know. It came out like right after I started playing.
They need to bring back PvE events, bro. Honestly, dude, that Odyssey event was super fun.
I just want the Odyssey Kane announcer back.
make sure you
during
pause.
The Odyssey event, like there was an actual Odyssey Kane announcement.
I'm not in the game yet.
Yeah,
so.
But when you do, I always have like a very, very slight lag coming in. So just
so we all just right, pause
we'll,
once
we'll
it loads.
Times.
Yeah, hold on. Yeah. Larkin's gotten that cool 350,000 mastery on Caitlyn. Really showing how long she's been on the top of U.GG's ADC picks.
Alright, okay,
I just got in.
Alright,
but like yeah, it's down. Still loading, yeah. I'm stuck at zero right now, but I think you guys should be as well.
Yeah, yep. I am also stuck at zero.
I'll tell you when I get in. Alright, I'm in. One, two,
I'm also
three.
In.
Okay, alright, we're good for now.
Alright, let's go. They're loading into the Rift at the moment. We'll see everyone do their usual Summoner's Rift intro dance for Vision. See if an invade will happen. I feel like, doesn't Team 911 usually invade?
No, they have a mixed history with it. Like mixed history isn't how often they do it, not their success rate. Welcome to Summoner's Rift. But, yeah.
Right now, 3:30. So, what is that, 8:30?
I feel like... Does he see it? Does he see this invade happening?
Looks like this is interesting. I like this. I got
okay,
the
Q coming out from Braum.
Scene,
I don't think
ward,
they do anything from
the
here.
Braum?
I see, yeah, okay.
They're all sitting on a ward. I feel like they should just, yeah, I feel like they leave.
That's what Rip Robert started the... I would have done the same too, started the yellow trinket, place it back at the sweeper, but it means you also can't clear that ward over there. So...
Well, I doubt clearing the ward is of
I mean
any
like apparently it
use.
Lets you I mean like if you clear it I'm pretty sure you get level 3 off of more easily.
Arda,
like, I think
apparently
you
minimized
like,
your app so I can't see the game.
What?
Yeah.
Impossible.
Just have like match stream it cuz I really need my maximize
I got it,
for
I got
the
it.
Twitch stream.
I got it, I got
we
it.
Cannot have this shit lagging.
No
again,
brother.
I swear to God.
So what are you guys on right now? You guys
131,
just
133.
Okay, yeah, I'm a couple seconds behind.
That's
okay.
Fine. Okay. Because
I mean, if anything, you just watch from my stream, so that's like three of us are.
I like watching. I like watching my own.
Yeah. You can press equal to speed it up a little bit, or minus to slow it down. Just, yeah.
Why would it
so
be?
Are you
plus?
Guys on 152
oh,
now?
Yes. Yeah. Yes. I'm a little behind you, but yeah.
Right, let's see.
Alright, well, Robert started off on his blue. I'm pretty sure that's standard on Volibear. It's not like Kane, where it's like three different ways to start off.
I mean,
in which this
there
Kane
there's always three
to
different
start
ways
red.
Anyway. He could go the wolves here, he could just go straight to the red, or an invade, or gank, or something.
Kane's weird,
like,
man.
Dimity on Shen once again.
Kane, this is standard stuff too. The red, the Krugs, the Raptors. Either gonna full clear, or something.
All right. A little bit of poke action happening in the mid lane.
Yeah, actually, I was just putting my camera over there too. You go with the level advantage.
Ooh.
I'm actually playing this.
Oh,
smart really
in the bot
sure.
lane.
Oh, bot lane. Okay.
Seems like.
Oh, but it looks like he actually made
a ignite
in
the fight.
Oh, first blood.
There's the Braum. First blood.
And in the mid lane, Miguel might actually get a solo kill of his own.
Oh, they're not able to get the double. Oh, Miguel is chunking out Luxter.
And
it's not looking good for bot lane.
That's something
in
the bot lane. All those shums gone in the bot lane. No, yeah, sorry about that. Yeah.
Ooh, I need to talk
more
happening talk in the top lane.
A double gank the top lane.
Flash from Robert. Oh, they're just not able to get it. Wow, like somebody flashes out right before he dies. Insane.
And they trade two flashes on the side of Team Segmentation Fault for one on Shen.
Big yikes.
Both junglers still hovering around their top side. Maybe Palace will try. Nope, there it is. He just straight up kills him. Okay.
Dang. Both junglers just gonna finish standard stuff. Kane doing the grump. Robert's gonna invade. And no sign of the Kane until he shows top. This is mostly standard stuff.
And Shen teleporting back to lane after getting solo killed. Oh, Miguel? Oh!
Gets the Flash almost gets the kill.
Yeah, that Fizz passive really cuffed him there.
29, 30 HP right now. That's crazy.
Oh, I missed the kill. What happened? What happened?
Thomas got Leximity.
Wow, good solo kill from Thomas. Nice.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what Thomas does now. He has complete control of the lane, pretty much. The wave is going to him. He decides to keep it in the middle.
The tracks, oh, they get back. Well, I think it's...
Oh,
it's not gonna push
it. Oh, Leximity actually W-ing that W.
Wow, Renekton's eyes glow when he has full fury, or like halfway.
Yeah, when he has halfway, yeah.
It's kind of cool. Okay, he goes back in for another trade. Just classify Renekton as a you know, as an assassin already, like burst bruiser. Might as well.
Yeah, he's just nasty. Oh, and there's
looks
more.
Looks like they're going for a play bot lane. Robert,
oh, another 3v3
counter gank here.
It seems like they've got the Leone.
The counter
dead to rights.
Wrong, unfortunately, they're gonna get.
Does
Leone.
He get it with the ignite?
Yeah, they're gonna get it.
Oh wow, that's
wow.
Arlen early dies.
That's what I like to call the fadeaway.
It's worth it. Orbs.
Oh, it's always worth it. Luxor in the middle lane.
See. I don't know. Mid lane matchup is so weird because either one of them post six could just easily. Oh well, it looks like Luxor might win this one.
Robert's here for the support.
I don't think he catches it, and there's no way that
at least it keeps Luxor away though. No.
Miguel can't chase because one E, you know, will just lose or he'll just die.
Robert keeps going, starts backing.
The Kane is looking like he might. Maybe not.
Yeah, I was looking forward to see the Kane tussle, and the Voidbearer as Conqueror too. So that was gonna. I'm curious to see how that would have gone actually, because I have no idea how that would have.
Again, Arlen has two kills in the bot lane and not giving any kills to the ADC. He's saying this is a Braum carry kind of game. Wait, Larkin went Kull?
Yeah, I was actually just about to mention that too.
Super try hard on doing.
I actually think that's pretty justifiable into an MF Leona. That's like really rough land.
Well, they seem to be doing just fine.
Yeah, but they didn't know
like
that from
Thomas
Chancellor.
Thomas is in the mid lane, chilling, seeing if something might happen. He's probably waiting for this Fizz to use E.
I think
Miguel's telegraphing. Nah, I feel like Miguel's telegraphing by like walking in front of the wave. Whole lot of farming going on.
This is where things
get
interesting because we have a Shen ult on the table now, right? Not used. Yeah.
Let's see. I feel like from other games, isn't Leximity a little slow on the uptake when it comes to ulting in team fights?
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I haven't really.
It might be a little difficult with their comp. They're able to like burst targets down with CC pretty quickly with the Ori, Ori Braum. I feel like there's potential for a wombo there.
Yeah, I don't really think that's in the fault of Leximity more so than the comps of 911.
No, definitely not.
Yeah,
his
fault. Like, I agree.
They don't have defined engage with like tanks very often. Like they'll have bruisers and stuff, which kind of adds to like half
like, wait, why is he leaving?
Oh, I feel so bad for Sagfault right now.
That was
a great
heal
and a kill.
That was so weird. They just left right away.
Yeah. Are they gonna get more?
I mean, I guess directly. Yeah, this is
Larkin's in trouble.
Failed flash by Leximity.
Taunt coming up, maybe.
I think that was actually the correct play by Team Segmentation Fault.
Think so?
But I'm not sure. I just don't know. But from a jungler's perspective, would be depending on which
ult
jungler
from
I am,
Miguel
really
in the mid lane.
Really
he's looking.
Happy.
He's looking for it. Ah, not enough damage. Jukes the Leona E.
Oh no.
Perfect Kane position.
Oh, he dodges the W,
but ult's still going off.
Yeah.
And that's the kill.
All right. Blue team's playing it well. They're able to even it out somewhat. Still a bit of a gold difference, but they got the drag.
Sinkfall still has a window where Kane doesn't have
three.
Yet, so.
Turret plates. Oh, and let's see if he can actually 2v1 here.
I don't think Big Snake Mouse is gonna go in for it. They saw him, so they know he's in the river. Looks like they're probably just gonna go for Herald instead.
It's just a Cinder Hulk. They're going for the Herald. And there's the pink board.
Maybe not.
Oh, they're not. They only went for the scuttle.
That was almost.
Robert's setting up for the top gank, but it doesn't seem like Jiminy is gonna even try and like walk up here.
Yeah, I feel like if you're Zangfault, maybe look for that Herald. Granted, I don't think they knew that the king back either, but I don't know. We don't know if he's still there.
Who's still here?
If you're Zangfault, you don't know if the king's still there. Maybe you do the Herald.
Thomas.
Oh.
There we go.
And there's a
huge amount of damage.
Now this is when you do the Herald.
He's Renekton. It doesn't matter if he messes up the combo. And hopefully the Horowitz brothers go and take Herald here. Or they might just try and shit up and take the tower.
Why not?
Oh no, that's a TP from like somebody.
There's a TP to save the tower. And no Herald.
Okay, opting for the Krugs instead.
Oh, the ult mid lane. Oh, I don't know if Miguel wins.
I do that a lot.
Well, Miguel wins that because of the exhaust. Exhaust is a great summoning spell.
Lord man.
That damage from the king does poke.
Wow. Good on Luxter.
Good on the team. They're able to like rotate really, really well.
And here we might see Arlen actually. Yep, he's gonna punish him.
Beautiful.
Yep. That was that's what happens when you're combo from the two.
Yeah.
That was beautiful.
Braum ult into Caitlyn trap.
The Arlen.
I don't even know if he trapped at that point. Yeah, I think he just had headshot up.
He did trap. He trapped. He autoed. It was actually amazing. We might have a 2v2
pretty,
top.
Pretty dope.
I don't know
about this. Oh, Luxivity actually misses the taunt.
Shows,
and
they just get out.
Robert's still not going for the Rift Herald.
I mean, the Kane doesn't have form. He's a little ahead, but he doesn't have form. So maybe this is doable. I feel like if you're Thomas, do you go to the Herald with him?
Yes. You push in the wave, and then you make it a choice for the Shen to either miss EXP or try to fight for the Rift. And if you get the Rift, then he just loses everything. It seems like now they might be trying.
Oh, mid lane. Luxter with the ult, lands everything.
Oh, he's going in.
Miguel
oh.
looks like he's in trouble. Oh, the flash coming from Luxter, the ult from the volley bear. Nothing much you can do. Shit. This is what I was. It's tough. You're out of position as the Ori. You're pretty much just boned. You can't out damage, you just die.
Oh man, I'm scared for Robert here.
It does seem like Robert is playing extremely passive.
He's behind the enemy jungler.
Yeah,
he's employing the Broxa level of gameplay here. Looks like this might be first tower to top lane.
No way he backs. Oh, he actually backed.
Oh no.
And this is the top. Yep. That's 610 gold just to Thomas.
Yeah, he's ahead.
He's a beefy boy. Already has the Bork.
Yep. And Nolan's actually itemizing against him.
I was wondering why. So the Kane got blue form first. So sadly, you can't see form timers, but. Yeah, so we're waiting on that. And
oh, is that an extra 3 minutes?
I don't have when it started. It's 4 minutes, and then I think it's 4 minutes or whatever it is. And then if he as he hits more melees, instead of getting orbs, you get a little, you get like a few seconds off of your form timer. So like if he hits melees, he'll get time off.
Looks like we're having a team fight on the bottom side.
Okay, the ult from Braum, ult from MF.
Combo's
doing a lot of damage. Leon is about to die, but no, not able to find it.
And that's
Shen ult saves. It doesn't really save anyone. He ulted the MF.
Arlen flashed over the wall, and
it was looking good until the entire team sort of rotated this. Oh, and we see,
Shen is very annoying.
We see Luxtur in the back. I think he just got caught out. Yeah. Thomas gets this one. Yep. Nice. They're on drag, but yeah, I think they get it. Yeah, that's drag.
Oh my god! That's red form and a lot for the Kane. But here comes Larkin. Larkin giving him the pew pew. Is he gonna be able to kill him before he falls too? And he does.
And get the blue chip tortilla ace. Triple kill the Larkin and double buffs. They just made Larkin a very happy person.
It is important to consider that Team 911 does have two Drakes at this point now. They do have a path to get out if they can grab
also
that soul
worth
early.
Orbs.
Well, also that, but they're down 5k gold at the moment.
Yeah, 15 minutes in, that's really rough.
Yeah, the two dragons really only matters if they can get to the soul.
It's true.
Yeah, this I think that fight just turned it over to Segfault's favor.
And here we still still do Rift Herald up.
Oh, they own an ult.
Go for something. Oh, here. Oh, and
Arlen's in the back as Braum forces the Leona flash. That's Braum's ignite.
Interesting thing I learned about the Kane transform is that you actually get the home guards if you transform from your Nexus. So you don't apparently you don't even have to do it from the fountain.
Oh really?
Yeah, you can also do things like Rift Herald through the wall, and apparently there's a new tech where you can like you can recall in walls too. You like press E, Q, and B at roughly the same time, because you normally can't recall in a wall, but if you do it out of your Q, for some reason you can. So you can actually recall in a wall.
It's just a bug.
Yeah,
It is a bug.
Yeah. Well, they usually patch those kinds of things out, so it's only going to work.
They haven't yet. It's been a couple days, but yeah.
No, it'll be next patch, so like next week or something.
Yeah.
A lot of stuff looking to happen in the mid lane. The 1v1 from Thomas.
Difficult for the team. Thomas is
good
big.
Ult from NF. Really does. On the wave is good, but Thomas just life steals it all back. It's pretty disgusting.
Don't do it.
We're getting the Arlen telling Larkin to stop whatever play they're making, as per usual.
Larkin missing that cannon for the entire camera to see.
Yep, I saw it too. Imagine having to farm minions. Oh my god, the Caitlyn damage.
Dude, that's what headshot damage does, man. It's just
looks
crits,
like the horror wire taking Herald. However,
that's a good trap for Caitlyn.
There's a possible
kill. That should be a kill. Yes. Wow.
Not anymore. Red team gets
Arkin
the Herald.
With these traps. He's pretty dope with it. Let's see if Robert can get out of this one. I don't think you should chase. It might be
a little
greedy. Actually, his team's not there. He's forced into ult.
Kane probably could have gotten it if he wanted to.
Yeah,
he probably could have gotten it.
I don't know, like,
Thomas is in the top lane, sitting in the jungle, ready to avenge his brother. He's like, oh, you trying to...
Flash in.
And there's the Kane R.
Oh, he's got to get out now.
He's out.
Did he miss? Did he? I don't think he hit the W this time.
No, he didn't. It was an...
Yeah, what the interesting thing about like when I'm a Kane fighting a Volibear is like usually like the Volibear is pretty far ahead of me for some reason because like I throw.
Volibear is better early game. That's the thing. Like Volibear is kind of like a jungle bully.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But that was a good reactionary good reactionary ultimate from the Kane.
Yeah, and to be fair, he probably shouldn't have ulted Robert also, because what if I don't know if he knew where everybody else was. Maybe he was walking into their whole team. Especially if Robert, like... Oh, no, he didn't have flash.
Oh, Arkan's possibly out of position here.
He does too much damage from him to be out of position.
Sound like Miguel with this LeBlanc.
Oh, here's where the fun begins.
Oh,
I want to see some. I want to see some blood by the red buff. And that's where I'm taking it.
He set the line.
The jungle camps.
He set the line. They can't cross this into this brush. They have to go all the way around.
Here's the setup for the third Drake.
I have to bring him up.
Alright, but they see he's in the, he's inside the pit, and they're looking to surround him, so this is...
Oh, this is getting interesting.
R.I.P. Leximity. That's kind of bullying. He actually flashes, too.
That's just rude, Larkin.
Yeah, this drag is pretty much... this.
Wait,
yeah.
Caitlyn can
bona fide some
what? What
property.
Am I looking at? Caitlyn can auto the dragon from outside the pit. Also,
oh,
look at
no,
this.
Larkin maybe.
Yeah. Oh, he flashes over, but now he's
so
not able to
close.
Steal.
That
he
really
he
close.
Could he, if he had smite and he was able to like you know flash smite right away.
Yeah,
he might have been able to get it. That was super close.
No, yeah, I was. That was almost.
That was
hard. Oh,
oh my god.
I hate Braum. Like one Braum Q, and you're just like you're either forced to flash to get away, or you just kind of like accept your fate.
Looks like the fight coming on top side.
Looks like Thomas is dead here. He has to be dead here.
Wait a second.
Oh no.
Oh no, he's dead.
He almost one shot the thing.
Holy crap.
He got ignited because he might have been able to queue after like another second or two.
No, he autoed the Shen. He actually could have lived and killed like Fizz at least if he didn't auto him.
And now here's a TP.
So, like so many TPs, I don't think that was needed.
Probably just miscommunication.
Or just making sure.
Yeah, it was probably just a misread. They assumed that Zek wanted to go in.
Yeah.
Larkin's
I
the one
the
with
time.
The Seg clan tag, yet no one else has it. That's kind of depressing.
Arlen doesn't have it? But he did.
Does he? Yes, he does. Sorry.
Yeah.
But, okay, actually, no, everyone does except for Miguel, who's too much of a K-pop stan to actually change his...
He's gotta have the twice, bro. Like, come on, man.
I mean, to be fair, they're probably the only one I've ever heard. At least female ones.
I have no secret. Yeah, game's looking pretty good for Seg right here, man. They're about to turn that 5k into a 10k gold lead pretty soon.
Apologies for not reading chat, but I'm just gonna look at some stuff. Casters, which team comp do you guys like better?
I personally think that team segmentation faults team comp is phenomenal.
They always play team comps for team fights. You know, it seems like Team 911's comp is like half team fight, half trying to go for picks with the Kane and the Fizz. You know what I mean?
Yeah, the Fizz does dive the backline very well.
Sorry, dude, I tried to flash on TV.
I don't know. I don't know which comp is better, but I know I'm happy to see Team 911's team comp simply because they have Kane and Shen, which are both extremely cultured champions.
I was gonna say like. Team 911 has had some fantastic like team play, like at least in terms of coordination, I think they're probably one of the best teams. I wish they went towards that more with probably not having the Fizz. If they had a control mage instead of the Fizz, like I guess the Vel'Koz would have been nice, but that would have been a fantastic comp I would have loved to see.
Yeah, the Vel'Koz was banned though, because they know that Leximity on or Lux, they're on Vel'Koz is pretty good. Donor as well, both of them are
beautiful,
very good.
Yeah. But... fortunate that
TP from
there and
from
the
Thomas.
Will fall.
Nice.
They're getting more.
Yeah.
Flash. There's an ult. A three-man stun now.
A three-man stun.
Godlike.
Pretty good. Pretty good stun from Leona.
Am I like ahead of you guys?
He's just getting run down.
I'm 24 out of 7.
We're
right
like
now.
20. Yeah.
Okay, I am a little. I'm a little behind you guys. I just don't want to be ahead.
Yeah. They're on Baron. Their jungler and the support died. There's no way that they contest this. This is in the bot lane, so free Baron to Segbald. What do we call the Baron boys?
What's
the?
Reborn Baron.
The original.
I think it was like State Farm.
No. The original is a beer company, as we can't say for legal reasons. So we can call
generic
it...
beer company, Baron Buff.
Yeah.
Wait, we can say Blue Corn Tortilla Chips, but we can't say, like, the other brands.
Well, that's because Blue Corn Tortilla Chips transcend copyrights.
Yeah, it's true. It's too generic.
What about the whole, like, what's that market that's like the, whatever market, white cheddar,
popcorn?
Good food? Yeah, Whole Foods, Whole Foods.
Oh, Whole Foods white cheddar popcorn.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure, right? Yeah.
No, you're talking about the black
Yeah, the black bag with white coat.
No, that's smart food, that's smart food, isn't it?
Smart food, alright. So they got the Smart Foods white cheddar popcorn.
Oh no,
Baron power play.
Speaking of Smart Foods, looks like they're trying to get the pick onto Thomas here.
Do they catch it?
That's a lot of damage.
That was a snipe from the Fizz.
Ooh.
A lot of stuff happening right now. Robert's stuck trying to get the backside.
Find the back line. Okay.
I had the Fizz ult on me.
Oh, they're all. Oh, he's living.
Oh my God,
Miguel's so able to get out. No way.
Oh my God.
He's just dodging everything, dude. He's
it's just.
Oh, they finally get him. But he dies for that. It's guaranteed. Holy moly!
Huge cost. Yeah, here comes Robert. Just gonna chase this guy down.
Oh, but Kaylin with the ult and the snipe. She was waiting for the jump.
She
had the whole time. She's just patiently waiting for him to finish the jump. That was a fantastic play on Larkin's part.
Wow, Miguel actually juke master right now. That was honestly, if he was able to get out alive there, I'm pretty sure that one play would have just made him the
MVP
player
game.
Of the series. Like, that would have just. Oh.
Lukester says in all chat it doesn't go off. He's probably referring to the Kaylin ult. Yeah, Larkin refers. Yeah, so Kaylin's ult resets down to 3 seconds if the projectile never left and the target became untargetable.
Yeah, if you ult someone and that target dies, then you get the reset, the cooldown.
No. If the projectile fired, it goes on full cooldown.
No, but I'm saying if the projectile doesn't fire,
yes,
then he gets the ult cooldown back.
If he just becomes untargetable for whatever reason, so like dying or like going invulnerable, like Elise Spider or the
I see.
Gladpool, or in this case the.
Well, you learn something new every day, huh?
Kane's looking for a gank here on the side. He's gonna be spotted out by Ward.
What a good display of sportsmanship between the two teams, clarifying ADC mechanics.
Wow, Larkin's going 10-0.
Yeah, he's been playing very
well.
Oh,
he would have been going 13-0 if our support didn't steal kills.
Damn, both
we gotta pay for support
items
somehow.
That is crazy.
We can say that Miguel is the inting one because he has the most deaths on the team.
He's actually negative, so you'd have to downtime report him after the game.
Exactly. Oh my god, they can't even touch Larkin.
That damage is just insane. It's bonkers, man. Who the fuck? Who released this champion? Like, he could tell you what? He could auto the tower out of range, bro.
When he has the rapid fire cannon proc.
Okay, I was about to say that's pretty Brock if you could do that like normally.
Kindred and Senna are the only other champions that can do that.
So they can legit like.
Oh no!
He cleanses the Leona ult. Oh, yeah, that's really good. The Shen ult going onto the Leona, he's able to go through.
There's a taunt.
Taunt onto the Larkin.
Oh no! Braum jumped into with the fish there, and it's a slaughter.
Into the Larkin.
There's a shutdown on the
game. Oh my god, the one place
that's
fish
two
is,
shutdowns
is
on
gonna
the game.
Be, yeah, shutting him down. That was insane.
Really good play from Team 911.
That is a big cane.
Yeah, that is a huge cane, and the fizz is probably big too now.
Got five that was really the unfortunate. Seal.
Yeah.
You just see Larkin get
depending
taunted.
On the
side. Yeah.
That Randuin is going to be huge on him too, and then he'll be able to put more damage or visage or a death stance or whatever.
How long until Baron's up?
You have 1 minute and 6 seconds.
What's the thing for like putting N. up the jungle timers?
N.
Ah, I see.
There we go.
I need to switch it. There's a special spectator one that looks aesthetic, like on the upper right, just shows Baron and Dragon timers instead of the buffs. But I need to change that in settings.
Mm. Yeah, this is NA production value right here.
Bruh. Honestly, I was looking at Twitch Rivals today. Were any of you guys looking at that shit?
Gosh.
No.
Nah. But I honestly might contest them for who has better production right now.
Oh? Oh, Miguel.
Wow, the double ult from Miguel. Yeah, that almost... If that Kane wasn't there, he probably would have been able to 100-0 the MF.
What items does Miguel have at 30 minutes? Oh.
He has Seraphs, Azanias, and Zork Shoes, and a 9-stack Dark Seal.
Summate, you didn't start the Dark Seal earlier.
I mean, he also died
actually,
three
times.
Actually,
he died four times.
Yeah, he died three times in lane, like in a row. I don't know if he wanted a Dark Seal at that time.
True. Looks like they're chilling in the brush, trying to see who's man enough to look at him.
I wonder if they have an idea or not. They don't seem to. They don't have vision.
Yep, they don't.
They start the Baron.
They do have it. They have an idea now.
Oh!
He needs to fight.
That's a three-man knockup from the...
Oh no, Larkin is getting CC to high health, but he has the Curio. And it does seem like...
I honestly
can't even follow
this.
Me
yeah,
neither.
I can't even follow with that. Oh,
Larkin's just getting hit by everything.
Larkin's just getting everything. Oh, beautiful!
Oh
lad.
My god. Team 911 actually wins that fight.
Yeah. They were able to get the pick onto Larkin.
Wait, where did Larkin die? Oh yeah,
yes.
They got him.
Yeah, Larkin got CC quite a bit, so he wasn't able to do the damage.
I feel like Team Stifalt just weren't able to like focus one person properly.
They also lost Braum before the team fight, which means that he wasn't able to peel for the UDC. And that was really critical.
I don't think they can get this. Yeah, I really, they don't get off.
Yeah.
Yeah, really not helping the fact that Kane has pretty much build full armor.
Yeah.
Really negating a lot of damage.
Yeah, that Randuin's is huge.
This is actually soul point for the team 911.
The ult thing to kick that dragon faster since the team's coming up pretty soon.
Oh, let's see.
They get it. And it's looking like that those two dragons are also paying some dividends. Another one from soul.
Let's see, does Robert figure it out? No. He does not know that MF is backing in Tribush. And looks like they're gonna go for the Baron again. While Larkin is taking blue buff?
They're going for the Smart Foods White Cheddar Popcorn Baron play number two. Wait, Larkin's able to... I guess I'm seeing something that he's not, because I thought I saw him auto three times without vision.
Yeah, I saw so too.
Probably an attack move kind of thing.
I don't know. But ADC is taking the jungler's camps.
Standard formula.
Why do you guys think Team Sekfol actually lost that last team fight?
Probably since Larkin died.
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like if Larkin's alive,
actually,
the fight's won.
The Horoi got picked first, I believe. So as soon as Thomas died, then.
I need to rewatch that because honestly, I could not follow it.
Yeah,
like,
there was a lot of visual stuff.
Like,
apologies to the spectators. I kind of zoomed out a ton, and the names took up most of the fight.
I think that that the moment Thomas flashed in for the Kane pick.
Yeah, you should have probably saved that for like an MF instead. Like,
or just like help or build up his rage so that way you could peel for Larkin even more.
Oh, some skirmishes are breaking out.
A little bit of poke here and there. They're poking them out.
Thomas
is in
the
bot
lane.
Yeah.
Does have teleport, so you can come to any team fight if necessary.
Interestingly, the Shen also has the teleport and the ult. So there's stuff that can be done there too. Can he match him though? I don't know.
Yeah, looks like he is going to match him right
okay,
now.
Okay, yeah, okay. Yeah,
two levels just... under and a full.
Whenever I'm on Shen, the Renekton's always so far ahead that I can't match him.
Well, it's looking like another one of those scenarios. The Shen went bot. They're chilling in the mid lane, clearing vision towards Baron. This is scary for Team 901.
Braum's kind of alone again. Got to really watch out and make sure he doesn't get picked again. It's really critical.
Larkin and Arlen really have to make sure they don't get caught out here.
Yeah. Looks like they're gonna back as the top side of Team 911 wants to collapse on whatever approach is happening there. But Seg's gonna back off.
Some nice relaxing farming going on here.
Everyone just casually getting their next item spikes. The Ocean Drake being pinged for
I don't know what else I should do,
for the possible soul point.
Arlen's not gonna be able to see the vision. Nope, that's it.
Yeah, that's a
score looking like
pain with the
86
stance,
87
on Arlen. Holy shit.
The rest of his team combined barely matches him. Actually, it's close, but yeah.
Well, no, I'm pretty sure three of them match him.
Yeah.
So that's a fuck ton of vision score. Holy shit.
Yeah. I don't think I've ever seen
really
Larkin hit double digits at 35 minutes in terms of vision score.
Well, that's how we know he's serious.
Actually, really interesting how Team 911 is actually like 8k gold up and they still can't. It still seems very even.
Yeah, I mean, it's just these assassins, these like high potential damage from the Kayn, the Fizz, and the MF, you know? They just do so much.
Yeah, literally just, they gotta peel for Larkin, honestly. They just have to make sure that he does the damage.
Larkin's full build now at this point, if you didn't notice.
Yeah, Larkin and Miguel are the win con.
Yeah, that's two like, and a half, or an item and a half on the MF. And he still has to play really patiently in these fights.
Oh, they might have been able to try to burst on the Kayn.
Yeah, interesting though,
because Kayn is the biggest threat.
Yeah. Thomas almost flame horizoning the Shen.
Oh, that's
what Flame Horizon? Is that the
100 Kino? CS diff.
What's that even from?
There's a Korean top laner named Flame who is famous for just absolutely destroying his enemy laners.
And this is the dragon fight we've been waiting for.
Let's see. I feel like they could do
the flash. There's the peel. There's the Kayn.
Ultimate Leona, ultimate MF. A lot of stuff going on.
Bomb
already dead.
Red team going to slowly take out the blue team.
Oh, the two carries of
able
Team
to get
911.
Healing barely, but like the Kayn is still on him. Holy crap.
Oh my god, that damage.
Oh my god. Wow.
Okay.
Wow, Larkin and Miguel are able to grab a teamfight win from the
clutch.
Honestly, actually insane.
Blue Kayn might have been the difference there. If they had just the lethality Kayn to be able to one-shot Larkin there, I don't know.
No, yeah, like that was what I was interested in champ select, because it's like I personally would go red Kayn into this, but it's like Blue Kayn, like if you can actually get onto Larkin and Miguel reliably, like Blue Kayn like isn't the worst thing.
Yeah, Luxor did a really decent job about like just engaging and diving their asses. The issue is that Robert literally threw himself, his entire body and life, just to make sure that they could stall it out for like a solid 6 or 7 seconds, which gave them the time to get off and actually able to peel. So even though the Horowitz got down, you still got Miguel and Larkin breathing.
The Horowitz line defending their carries to their last breath.
Exactly.
Truly an honorable line.
Uh-huh.
That makes you want to have their babies.
Me too.
And that's why they get the award of Segmentation Simps of the Year.
Let's go!
All I'm saying is that Nicole and Robert's girl, they're very lucky.
Lily? Yeah, Lily. Wait, no, her name's not Lily, it's Oh, I see
Lucy,
like an
Lucy,
I don't
Lucy. Lucy.
Lucy.
You mixed up Lily and Lucy the opposite way now.
Like, it's definitely not Lily.
Their names are super similar. I wasn't thinking like Alex S is like friend group Lily. I was thinking like, I don't know why Lily came up in my head.
So we... You're talking about the deer, aren't you?
Lilia? Yeah. After she made me take off my clothes.
Oh my god.
Can't stop thinking about
again.
It.
Baron fight might actually pop up here. I actually think that
Team 911's in position.
Team 911 might actually come out in this fight.
Yeah, it looks like they're trying to do some kind of collapse onto Larkin here.
Oh, yep. It seems like there's going to be a 2v4 basically here.
Oh, nope. They look like they're trying to Dunkirk it out.
Very tough. Very, very hard plays to make as Team 911. You have your priority targets. You know who they are, but it's just so difficult to be able to get on top of them.
Well, and then the bot side, Thomas was able to finally siege that in him. Turn.
I wonder why Thomas didn't try to fight the Shen.
Looks like we might have the start of a team fight. Yep.
Oh, no, no. They're, oh, wait, they are.
Yeah.
Both lands onto Miguel. Miguel goes golden.
Yep.
They're sitting on a ward, so
everyone
911 is
so
able to see
they want to be really careful
exactly where they are.
Oh, wait, this might be the end.
There's a blue smite. This could be the pick on the Kane. There's the
Thomas DPs.
This will be the pick on the Kane.
He's just so tanky!
And Kane is dead.
They're
now
able to finally get him. They should just leave. Oh, Luxter is trying, but nah. Mm-hmm. After the Kane dies, I'm pretty sure that's just it.
That is just it.
Yeah. Unfortunately, that was a really bad place to have to fight because they went through the wall, so Kane was kind of separated from the rest, which gave the segmentation fault the opportunity to just do a front to back they've always wanted. Even though Robert ulted in a very strange direction there to go onto the Kane, it still wasn't being able to be punished.
All right, let's see what they do with the Smart Foods. Is it Smart Foods White Cheddar Popcorn? Baron play.
Baron play, yes sir.
Essentially, this entire game is just protect the Larkin.
Yes.
Protect Larkin simulator.
Even Miguel used his ult in an inopportune time just to delay the Fizz from getting onto the team.
Yeah, he was getting Luxter off of
there
Larkin.
There was no damage there. It was literally just the CC.
Oh, but the main carries, Kane and Fizz, are now back up again. Let's see what they're going to do.
Yeah, well, they lose mid and bot inhibitor. This is great for team. Yeah, wait for Team Seg. They're looking for this next drag in a minute. That's gonna put them on soul.
Team Seg.
Is anyone?
Right now.
Oh, thank God. Is anyone gonna get that cannon mini, or they're just gonna run away from it?
That is the question. Okay. Larkin was in a really dangerous position there.
Oh, they might be able to get Miguel here. Alright, well, they reset.
Ult should be back up along with
Larkin hasn't needed to buy an item for like 12 minutes now.
just casually 15 and 10. And now he has red buffs, gonna be even harder to get to him.
Yeah. It's tough, man. This is super tough.
Yeah. Honestly, both teams playing pretty well. They had
this is true. Team 911 had some pretty good potential to come back. They were looking like they were gonna make it.
I just think 911 needs to get the good engage, right? They got the people to do it. They got the Fizz. They got the Kane. They just need to choose the right moments in the right places. You know,
exactly.
That was just the wrong place there. If they were able to choose like a better part of the river, they honestly might have just won that instead.
Dude, can you believe that Team Segmentation Falls up 12k gold? It does not feel like that at all.
It's still. I mean, at this point, we're getting close to full build, right? Gold's gonna stop mattering very soon.
Gonna be three to three on dragons, and this is
oh my god!
Leona's looking for a flank here.
Oh my god!
That
is disgusting. Oh. There's a
flank.
Looking like a shockingly familiar team fight here. Robert sacrifices himself again, but Larkin's able to survive.
Luxtur does get Robert, for Larkin, but that's it. Yeah, you just get an angry bear.
It's again, it's literally just Robert for the team, right? Like, he just
Robert ults on everyone just to get him away from the team. He's like, don't worry, boys. And, I got this.
Yeah, and the super minions are coming into Nexus.
I don't know, I mean, like, if I see a giant bear about to slam dunk me, you bet I'm gonna ignore Larkin and start just wailing on it. Like,
yeah.
that's just a fact of life.
So yeah, this is looking like game here. They're just gonna push the wave in and end. Yeah. Both teams play this super well, but Larkin is just
a large difference.
They gotta ban that Kayla next game.
We might see
one shot each other there.
If he landed the ult, he would have died. Yeah. Larkin would have died 100%. GG, great play.
Segmentation fall.
A very hard-fought battle.
Yeah, good stuff from both teams.
Credit where credit is due. Team 911 really was close to winning that.
This is true. They had the comeback like coming up. It's just that after one team fight, it kind of just fell apart.
All right, looks like we're probably gonna get into game soon. Yeah. Yeah, Robert is not afraid to sacrifice his body for the team.
Yeah, that takes heart, man.
Yeah, let's look at the damage here. Larkin just outpacing everyone here.
Larkin, he's just crazy, bro. That was.
Larkin's crazy, right? The support is crazy.
Arlen, you kind of ran it down, like, I feel like one or two times in team fights, bro.
Positive stream. Okay, honestly, MF was pretty, like, beat everyone else in damage besides Larkin. She was able to put in work. I think the issue is just, like, the engages, you know?
Those ults were super good. She had good ults.
Yes, if she just wasn't behind in items like that, she probably would have been able to just destroy teams here. You know, she was able to do that early on, but it just fell off eventually.
Yeah, Team 911 had a good ability to like funnel the enemy team in a way that MF was able to get like 4 or even 5 man ults consistently.
Yeah.
So, you know, I feel like it was just they fell too far behind.
All right, looks like we're gonna get into game 2 soon.
Yo, can you guys invite the other goon squad? You can't invite because one of you guys has to leave. Arigatou gozaimasu. Get in the spectators, Matt. Get in the spectators, Matt. Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Andrew, are you gonna spectate?
Yes. Well, I'll watch from the stream.
Okay. You'll watch from the spectator stream?
Thomas left for a certain reason. All right. Well.
Yeah. I'll watch from the stream.
Okay. He said he'll watch from the stream, Arlen.
Well, we can invite him now.
No. He said he'll watch from my stream. It's okay.
Okay.
All right. Hold on a second. It's Oreo hours. Give me a minute.
What flavor?
Either the double stuff one or those carrot cake ones.
Not the carrot cake.
They're actually good. They're low tier Oreos, but they're top tier snacks. Like they're completely outclassed by the double stuff Oreos, but they're still insanely good.
Listen, yeah. I got a controversial opinion here. I don't think Oreos are that good, honestly. They're not a good snack in my opinion.
That is sacrilege.
I can understand why someone wouldn't like it. Like I'm not a fan of Oreo ice cream, but I've grown to like them a lot more. Like you appreciate the simplicity, you know?
There's the Caitlyn ban. Anyway, I'll grab my stuff. I'll be back.
Was kind of annoying. Like early game, he was kind
the
of
game buggers. Two here. Andrew, what do you think 911 has to do to make the comeback?
911, I feel like
they had Leona.
Hey, you're lost. But I get it.
Wait,
Andrew.
We wanna first make a colleague.
Andrew, are you alive?
Well, guess not.
It's just in, folks. Andrew just died.
Rest in
breaking
peace,
news. Now, who will run it down as Yona?
No! You can't say that. Oh my god. You toxic.
Well, it looks like Team 911 ban out the Caitlyn and the Ezreal. They don't want to see that Caitlyn again. Team Sec ban out the Kayn. They're like, nah, I'm done with that Kayn. That Kayn was too big of a nuisance. Arlen's a good commentary in the back.
Are you certain?
There's a LeBlanc.
The Akali is up for Miguel, so could be a spicy play right here.
Look, you wanna...
Here comes the brand jungle, Luke says. Oh, challenging with the Akali.
I knew it. I see. Told you. Akali's up. Miguel's like, give me that shit. Yoink.
Akali versus Veigar mid lane? I don't know, Josh. I'm... There's probably much safer choices, right? Like, although you have performed excellently in those matchups, I do remember.
We'd
rather probably have, like a Morgana mid or something like that. I guess that's a blunt counter. Janna. Oh,
it seems like Andrew has left. RIP to a real one. No, the Zoe. I don't know, permanently. He left the Clover.
Oh, rest in peace.
Wait, he went to Gamer City Square. What the fuck?
I can move him.
If you wanted to do that.
Andrew, are you alive?
But you think you wanna
guess not.
He's been assimilated. He's an alien now, boys.
All more for the hive mind.
Okay. I fucking told you to pick Ashe. Big brain caster IQ.
This is interesting. I'm excited to see the Akali.
Yeah, if anything.
Okay, Ashe, Leona. They've practiced this. Arlan's able to play really well with this Leona pick, especially since Leona's totally not busted and an extremely fair champion at this moment in time. Fucking max CDR Leona can literally ult 2 times in team fights.
Oh, Andrew's like, having a Discord technical difficulties, as I can read.
Ah, okay.
We can actually ult 2 times in team fights as Leona.
Yeah, yes. I'm pretty sure the ult goes down as low as like 19 seconds.
What?
Super low. Leona's is like the same thing.
Leona's max level ult is like around 40 seconds, which means that with 40% CDR, it goes down to like 20 something seconds.
Finally. Oh, that's just nasty.
All right, looks like Andrew's back.
Hello, Andrew.
Hello. All right, so let's see. All right, good choices banning out the Caitlyn and the Renekton.
The Zoe's gonna be played. Sweet Jesus, my trigger senses have already been tangled.
What?
I've not banned any champion besides Zoe for over a year and a half now. I still freshly remember out of like released Zoe so vividly in my mind that I will never see it in my games ever again.
So I go. What was released Zoe? Ooh, Shen ban.
Have you never seen the comps? Like the compilations? Mm-hmm. There's one.
Like the 200 years of experience.
Yes,
2 years of fun.
That's probably the one. Like even like pro Zoe can just one shot an ADC and like just win fights instantly. Like it's not that you're
still balanced.
Not one shots are still balanced. Yeah, of course. It's not necessarily that her win rate was crazy. It's that she was a fundamentally broken champion in so many ways. Like she's the only champion in the entire game who can recast an ability during Zhonya's. She's literally the only champion
that
can cast abilities during Zhonya's. Oh, okay, it's supposed to be Zac jungle.
Can we talk about...
Curious. Looks like we might have a remake here.
I don't know if there's a remake.
Probably finish up the draft, then change to blind pick and just do a quick draft, if I assume.
This is why pro draft is superior. So you don't have problems like this.
Yeah, it has been stated in chat that it's supposed to be Zac. Oh, they're going to have to do a redo. Yeah, they'll finish then reset. Alright, seems like the most efficient way. Oh, and that's gonna be the set.
Thomas getting the DO special on the drop.
Alright, now that they memorized the draft, I didn't memorize the draft, but I hope someone memorized the draft. They'll be able to get back on that.
I think I remember Sykfault's team. It was Ashe, Leona, J4, Zeph, and Akali.
Now I'm angry.
All right, let's see what they spell out here. This is important.
It's probably ass, if I had to guess. Oh, wait. Oh, they have 5 bans. I'm scared. I'm not gonna lie. Well, I guess we'll see.
Don't think you a big sissy.
A-M. Oh, no, A-D. I can't.
For some reason, I thought Dr. Mundo was an M. I have mini brain.
What must be done?
S, okay. Team 911 opting for the meta. In spelling out, it is indeed ASS from Team 911. Team Segfault looking like they're spelling out A D A.
No, it's A S.
Is D is Dr.
A A M N.
I was curious because a part of me wanted to see like Janna in a solo lane or something. That would have been kind of cool.
Like Janna top or something?
Yeah. I mean, not for Thomas's sake, but it would have been pretty funny to watch. Oh no, I don't play much top lane, but as a melee top laner, I'd be suffering.
It's gonna be the Aphelios, spam. I guess I can understand what you're saying, Lily, but both teams agreed to it. I think if Segmentation Fault contested it, it would be fine. But you know, it's like both teams are okay with it. Sportsmanship. You know?
What was the question in chat?
Lily was just curious about why 911 was able to do the remake because one of their players didn't own the champion. But if Segmentation Fault agreed to it, I don't see the issue with it. Like they, you know, both teams are okay with it.
Yeah, I don't think. Yeah. I feel like I don't think they should be forced on that if one of the players doesn't own the champion.
Well, I mean, we've had the issues that drafts before that the only reason why it didn't work is because a player didn't own a champion. But yeah, I think true. If both teams are okay with it, we can do the remix.
Yeah.
So I don't know. That's fine.
Also, why I use Pro Draft.
Yeah. I mean, Pro Draft has
like
its own issues.
A little, yeah, and it's still a hassle to set up, but at least like everybody has every champion.
Yeah, it's like another half a minute to the already 3.5 minute delay that we have. So, kind of rough.
Okay, let's look at these team comps. So, I guess what does each team comp do?
We got a pretty standard team comp from 911 with the pick on Zoe. With it's like a team fight comp with a pick version on Zoe.
Like
and
an
then,
all-round team, I guess?
Yeah. And then you got something actually relatively similar with Team Segmentation Fault wanting like a pretty standard team fight thing, but they also get the assassination on Akali.
Alright, like 70's on this famous Trundle. However, it does seem like Team Segmentation Fault's team comp just kind of stomps 911's.
So?
Yeah.
Well, so what makes Segmentation Fault's comp stomp so hard?
So let's say set just for off the set, right? Zach jumps in on them and Thomas just R's Zach back into their team. Right. So that's a lot of damage, a lot of CC going on there. Mm-hmm. Right. And then J4 ult traps maybe like 2-3 people. Right. And they can't get out. Leona R's into that one. That's 3 people stunned.
Oh,
and Akali just.
Wait
yeah.
a second.
Yeah. Oh my God, I think nasty. A lot of it. Yeah, that is nasty. Although I think a lot of it can be saved by how skillful the Janna plays. I think if
that's
the Janna
true.
Does well, she can prevent a lot of the issues that you're pointing out here.
That is true. It could happen.
Then all you have to do is worry about, like, you know, Ashe.
plus you get things like multi-man stuns from the Zac followed by an MF ult or something.
Yeah.
So, I guess it could go either way.
Yeah. I mean, yeah.
I think it definitely
goes into Segmentation's fault favor in just terms of raw team comps.
Yeah.
And it's going to be very pivotal on the Janna to figure out how this game's going to go. How are your semesters been so far?
Decent.
Yeah,
busy,
they're okay.
Are you in the same? Oh wait, no, you're not even in CS. Andrew, you're in CE, right? So.
Yeah, CE. So I am learning about operating systems this semester. So.
Yeah, I'm doing Verilog stuff right now for my digital design class. That's a.
Oh, Verilog. I remember.
Operating
that.
Systems suck. Oh boy, I can't wait to learn how a fucking computer starts up and runs its startup programs. Let's go.
Oh, that's no.
BIOS. I guess. OS
operating labs system. Looking like the Windows XP startup sound every time.
It's true. It's just literally how to program the picture of the startup, like the little landscape that the show.
Do, 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 do.
Yeah, exactly. 20 seconds before getting into game. Any other moments? Any other final comments before?
Are we about to see the Leximity
Trundle?
Yes, Trinity sir. Force rush again?
I believe so.
To be fair, it's not a terrible choice into their team comp.
No, yeah, I'm a
fan. I feel like TMAT rush is way better.
Thank you, Luke, for the final comment right before game.
I mean, there has to be. I think there is legitimately a good reason.
Oh, Artie, you have to restart the stream again.
I got you.
Because, like, think about it. Like, if he gets like a kill or two, he probably just hyper snowballs. So, it makes sense, I think.
Thank you.
Well, it seems like in the skin game, Team 911 win it this time. Looks like both ROI are broke.
Oh. You can't just.
Like, just spend money on League, dude. Like, what?
Oh my god. Toxic motherfucker. Let's see here. Like, I love the candy.
I don't know. I mean, Arlen has the. They have the Project Ash and the Lunar Eclipse Leona.
And Forecast Jan has a pretty decent skin.
I'm not gonna lie.
911 definitely wins with experience. I'm in game now at 0 seconds, just stuck.
Stuck as well.
Yes, sir. Wow, when you're loading into the game, the Titans in the back of the
game
of
have
the
a help
Nexus,
bar?
Yes. Yeah.
Super
cool.
Yes. It's because Riot codes its game in minions, so the way it can tell if you're healing from a fountain is by the distance to that statue.
Wait, you do more healing the closer you are?
No. It's how it can tell you should heal you at all.
Ah,
and like where you respond is based on that statue minion.
They need to make a Zac skin. Why don't they make the tuxedo Zac skin? Wait, did they? What was
I think
it?
So.
Are you guys at 30 wrong? Seconds?
Yes.
Okay.
Looks like we're gonna have a team fight. Or no, both teams walk to each other and everyone decides not to cast a single
they play
ability.
Chicken.
Peace, says
like,
Larkin.
Hawk. Classic.
Spam this boner to help donor.
Minions have spawned. Flash up in 9 minutes.
I feel like the coding for that is actually pretty well, though. If you classify every every unit in the game as a minion, then it's
like Talia's wall. It's literally just a line of like 18 minions. I think it's actually more than that, but yeah.
But they're not targetable. So.
Non-targetable, no health bar. It does have its own issues to do that, though. I mean, like think about
it.
Right?
I'm sure it has like a health bar just to have one, just because it is classified as a minion. I'm pretty sure all minions are.
The
like,
nice
it has
thing...
like 9,999 health.
No, I don't think it does have a health
bar.
It's
I think it probably has like negative one.
It's probably a single health. It's like one health. Oh fuck, I'm freezing. Okay.
But it's like untargetable?
Yes.
So in that case, even though it has one health, you're not able to actually hit it.
What was I gonna say? Yeah, the thing about that is it makes it really easy to implement it in like tests. Like game designers are able to just make a fake champion almost instantaneously, just because of how easy it is to make the abilities and stuff. But like long term sustainability is kind of meh.
Is that a chroma for
oh
for that skin for
which
for Akali?
Yes. What? I think yes, that is the white chroma of the true dam. No, KDA skin.
No, that's true damage. True damage.
Or true damage skin. Yeah. Either way, PP hard.
I mean, all
looks like
all Kali skins.
Thomas in the top lane is just beating the shit out of this troll.
Yeah,
he's like, come here, bro. Let me punch you in the mouth. I know Luke has had trouble against that. Yeah, I don't know, dude. Set is just—he's a lot of fun to play, but he's in like a weird state. I feel like at the moment.
Here's a gank in the mid lane.
He's in a very weird state.
There's flag.
Right
there's the beautiful.
No,
there's
the flag.
The sleep.
Trouble Bubble's able to land. That's the first goal.
Oh,
line.
The response kill gonna come
oh,
in.
Oh no! Oh no! Oh, Robert, no! Robert, why would you go that way?
Yeah, that
why
was a very dangerous method.
I'm pretty sure.
Backs against the dark seal.
I thought Miguel would win that.
I mean, she did. Man. He did, right?
For yeah,
no, but I feel like I thought Miguel wins the 1v1 with Zach.
Yeah, but Zach can get out.
He's too tanky. Yeah. He just walked away.
Like if they were forced to 1v1 each other, probably, but.
Wait, so who's the next champion gonna be? Didn't you guys say it was like an ETH champion?
Yes.
Yeah, it's what's her name? Seraphine? Yeah.
Seraphine, yeah.
Yeah, Larkin,
they made like a little there. She's one of the champions that gets like a really big marketing campaign, so she has like real fake social media accounts and it's got SoundClouds, Twitters. She even has like a comic.
Oh,
forces like somebody to flash. That was a huge combo from Thomas on the set. God, set is just so much fun to play.
I mean, it's literally Dio as a league champion. It's not to love about that.
All right, let's see. Can Arda, can you actually click on yes, Thomas yes, just yes, to make yes, sure? Yes. I want to see what he. Oh,
looks like we might have a team fight in the bot side here.
Oh, the trouble bubble lands onto Robert. He's not able to get out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Looks like the Dark Seal is paying off for Luxor Zone. Already.
Yeah.
Yeah, Arda, can you just click on Thomas? Oh, actually, good. He is maxing Q, thank God. Whoa.
Yes, you want the Q max, especially if he's going to be going for Bork first item.
Ooh.
It looks like something might happen in the mid lane.
That door thing.
What?
Set in
yes.
Every lane is a
yeah.
thing, dude.
Hey, yeah, it's not nearly as strong as it was before, but it's still pretty strong.
Like, set mid is still okay.
I'm surprised that they didn't whip out, like, any Pantheon support. I thought it was busted.
Neither team probably practiced it. And, like, it's one of those things you really don't want to cheese unless you practice as a team. Like, it's fine in solo queue, but I think a constructed play like this, it just doesn't make sense.
Oh, God, dude, I keep waking up at weird times in the day.
Yeah, Sam.
When did you wake up today?
I woke up today at, like, 11:30, dude. Yeah. I hate waking up that late.
Yeah,
well,
Bubble
does not
flash,
land
like,
onto Miguel. Oh, Miguel ults?
Oh, well,
looking
this is dead. Yeah.
Wait,
he's not going to be able to get it.
Oh, wait, he doesn't? Okay.
Did he use his
R2?
His second...
Yes. Well, he has to.
Oh, he didn't use it on Zoe.
Yes, he didn't use it on Zoe yet. But that's really good on Zoe's part.
Oh, gank in the top lane. He ults onto Zach, flashes immediately. Oh, pretty
good. That's really
yeah.
good. Yeah.
He's gonna be able to
play Thomas. Oh, they have to get. Oh, yeah, they're gonna make it again. Oh,
it doesn't look like Larkin's. Oh, Miguel in the mid lane. Is that? Oh, you missed the Q!
The one for one, unfortunately.
No.
Yikes on me.
Wait, does the double ignite do more damage?
No,
I don't think so,
it
right?
Refreshes it.
Yeah. Oh my god. I choked on my fucking saliva when I saw Miguel miss that Q. I'm sorry,
no.
Miguel.
Positive stream, guys. This is
positive, stream,
nice.
positive stream.
Yikes. Oh, and Robert misses the cannon.
On the camera,
hey,
too.
I do it, too.
Yeah, don't worry, Matt. We tell you as well.
Also, you've been playing for like twice as long as you, Matt. If not longer. Either way, positive stream. We'll keep it the positivity here. Everything's happy.
Oh, the triple land onto Dixon. Not Dixon, Miguel.
And Luster's able to chunk him out for like down to 200 health here. Zoe showing that wonderful skill and balance that champion oh so wonderfully deserves. As it looks like the Horrorwire may be looking for a gank.
This is that twin telepathy, he knows. Oh,
but unfortunately, Robert is level 5.
That's the sleep onto the Akali. Gonna chunk him out again down to 200 as Miguel decides this is the time to fight.
Oh!
Ooh.
Oh, he does actually get it.
She outplays it.
Yeah,
wow.
If Zoe
Miguel
flashed
just...
there, the W would have killed the Akali.
This is why you ban the Akali.
Yeah.
Incredible play.
That was just insane balls on Miguel right there. Like, all right, 200
he
health.
He knew the damage
fight.
With this
what
champion. This is what Mastery does.
Who
you
does
know
that?
Exactly how
Who
much damage.
It's so fun to watch Miguel because, like, even when I'm watching them, like him and Larkin doing their rankings, like, 200 health. All right, everyone's at 200 health. Somebody's about to die. All right, let's go fight. Yeah. Like he does not hold back.
Oh, that's interesting. How did Thomas end up at an EXP loss here?
Thomas.
Oh, moving over.
That's gonna be the gank here. That's the Cataclysm. And they're just gonna be slowly whacking him as Robert's gonna get credit for the kill.
Robert's hitting him with the pole. Or Thomas is punching him in the face. As for usual, nothing happening in the bot lane. It's looking like a far fiesta.
Snooze fest.
I mean, you say that now and then.
And then we see Larkin get a ninja tabbies. Oh, nope.
No, he didn't get ninja tabbies. Okay. Zach in the top lane. He's gonna get the stun.
Actually, it's gonna be a dead Thomas.
Yeah, that was fantastic.
Great use of his
Zach's
ulti, like layering CC. That was a good play by the Zach. Mm-hmm.
Perhaps a scary premonition for what's to come.
Ooh.
That's the scary thing. It's like Zach scale.
Wow.
Like I don't.
Zach
like
scales fairly
Jarvan
well,
because it's like on Jarvan, I feel like I'm on a timer. Whereas
Zach will always be useful with those CC, you know? It's just so much and it's one kit.
Oh, and here we go again.
Sleepy Trouble Bubble does land, however. I don't know if going
oh,
in
I don't
was
know
the
about
play
it.
There.
You got the that tower shot kind of just sealed the deal here.
But ult from Leona on the Janna.
Interesting fight.
Oh, Larkin ults. That's looking like another kill.
Oh no, Arlen
steals
once again
it.
Taking away.
Reporting the
That's the one shot onto Zach. I think Arlen was a little too close to the Zach.
Larkin should actually be able to kill Zoe here.
Fight still happening, guy. We're getting some blood,
Yeah, Zoe's blood.
Oh no.
Yeah, there he is.
Man. Oh, the one auto, but okay.
If Leona was able to stun, that might have went a little better.
Yeah, that was a 3-for-2, I believe, from Team's 9-1-1 side. And that gives Zoe 3 stacks as she dies.
Bot's missing.
It's pretty decent.
It could be, like,
and that's also
that
drag
also gives,
for Team 9-1-1.
That gives drag for Team 9-1-1.
Both sides are having an even gold lead here.
Yep.
Neither one able to take a tower.
Oh, maybe Miguel can do something.
Is he gonna go for it? That's the question.
Oh,
that was very close.
Could have happened.
Yeah, I didn't even see Robert smite it, but apparently he did. Probably just an instant moment for both junglers there.
Yeah. Oh,
he ults
I don't know
under
about this.
Tower. Oh, he flashes on top of him. Does he die?
No,
barely.
Yeah, that was an interesting choice. If he flash autoed and then kept the W, he probably would have survived.
Yeah.
Oh, another fight in the mid
lane. Here. All right, now Miguel gets
it. Does have the
port
now, though.
Miguel was able to get the full combo.
Never mind.
I don't think so.
He
missed the ult, I think.
Luxor portal hopped the second ultimate.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well that's the ult from Larkin.
Oh yeah.
Wow.
So what
they just chain CC'd.
Zoe ult is a portal hop. It's a 10-second jump.
7 seconds.
10. It goes down to 7. But it just brings her from one place to another. That's all it does. And she's guaranteed to go back there no matter what.
Yeah, even if she gets stunned, she still goes back to her original
The important part is her Q's damage scales with distance, so she's able to get these long-range snipes, creating the oh-so-wonderful champion design of an artillery mage that one-shots. Kind of like Xerath, but no skill.
Great play from Larkin and Arlen. They were able to
get a tower play.
Chain the CC. Not even that, just earlier on the kill on Donor.
One-shot onto MF, yeah.
Yeah, the Ash ult is gonna be super annoying later on in the game.
Like it's nice that Larkin's getting fed here, but you got Zac and Zoe just ready to one-shot and jump on your ass, you know?
Yeah.
It's really gonna be up to the top side here and like the front line of Team Segmentation Fault to peel away 911's very, very aggressive hands.
Full tank Zac still one shots.
Bot side just got a massive power spike with the Bork finished for the Ashe as well as the Knight's Vow finished for Leona.
Damn, look at that. Just a single combo from Thomas just brings him down to half health.
Yeah.
She walks up halfway.
Kali looking for approach, but it's going to be spotted out if she goes for it. Are they going to go for a tower dive? That's the question. I guess that's kind of
I think they're just gonna go for plating.
But it looks like Zoe and Zac are coming.
He leaves tower range.
Oh man, Thomas can't get
in. Thomas can't get in.
But he's able to get the stun.
I don't know about that
one. Ximity.
Oh,
I do not know about that play.
Oh man, I feel.
Thomas should be beating the shit out of Zac right now.
They're able to get the Zoe. Wow, I didn't even see that.
It's probably more important to keep Miguel alive. But Zac continues to chase.
Oh,
misses the Q.
Fancy peep.
Gets the small fight, yeah. And Thomas is now alone in the 1v3. Honestly,
yeah.
This Zac put
it went wrong because of the
Zac. Oh man.
Yeah, that Zac.
He didn't put down the wall. He didn't put down the Cataclysm wall. He wasn't able to like get the set in the fight.
Mm-hmm. Have we seen Big Stank Mouse on Zac? I think a couple times, yeah, right? I don't think he's ever performed this well though. He's really showing up here.
I think it's more
another wombo combo happening in the bot lane.
Unfortunately, Larkin kind of committed to the tower too much there for it to probably. Oh, is he able to?
No, they still get it.
The final pick.
Wow.
Yeah, they still get it.
Is Zoe gonna be able to get a recovery kill? Does land the slow? Is he able to get the sleep? Arlen sacrifices himself by just jumping into the Zoe. However, Zoe still has two levels.
I don't know about the Zoe.
Zoe stole every summoner spell that was used in that fight.
Man. Yeah, well, that's how it is. You just walk into 14 minions and don't care because you just one-shot the ADC anyway.
Yeah.
We also have a Rift Herald on Big Stank Mouth and the Dragon coming up soon as well, so...
Here you can actually see that Team Segmentation Fault's habit of not taking early rifts is actually damaging them a lot.
Yeah, it just drags out these games a decent bit. But also, you're not taking advantage of the top side advantage.
I don't think he's ever gotten low enough to proc his passive.
Don't use it. It's like
the cell division.
Getting, denying it from the other team at least.
Like for example, the fight top lane could have gotten much better had Robert taken the time for Rift Herald instead and then ganked up.
Oh, looks like we're having a little skirmish top. Thomas gonna chunk him out again to half
even
health,
even ult.
Yeah, with the ult. All those resistances, all that health was stolen and it still didn't matter. Thomas was able to chunk him without even using his ult.
And here we can see that Trundle is just not the best champion in this meta right now. It's very unfortunate.
Damage with four.
Yep, you're just like beating the shit out of you. You can't do anything. Thomas should be able to get the tower here.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. He just beats him twice. Oh. Yep. Ooh.
Good play. Flash ult gets the stun off the E.
And
solid play from Thomas.
Yeah, it looks like a fight might break out any second in the mid lane here as they're approaching that mid tower. Really want to crack it. Oh, no, looks like they're probably pushing for Dragon. Zoe's looking at all sides, all angles, trying to get the steeps.
And
no teleport on Thomas either, so this could potentially turn into a 4v5 if the Trundle ends up over there.
What is strange is how they see all the rest of the four members of T9 on a map, and Thomas does not opt to
Looks like we're having a fight.
Deep trouble bubble does land onto Robert.
Just trapped the Zac in there, I suppose.
Not the play you want to make. Wow, that damage from the Zoe.
That's a really pretty insane decision. And a fantastic pick from the Zac there.
That's an awkward position to be in if your team's deck falls. Once again,
Thomas looking for the steal potential.
Thomas got hit by the bubble. He didn't have W because he used it.
Yeah, to try to steal.
He tried to use it to steal, yeah.
However, Miguel is here. Doesn't have the shot.
He's not able to get it.
One shot. If the Janna shield wasn't there, there's a decent chance that MF was dead. Again, Janna just showing the importance. Although, honestly, the Zac and the Zoe are just putting in so much work here. Fantastic plays from Big Stank Mouse and wonderful balance from Zoe.
Alex, in the chat saying, I vote we permaban Zoe in all tournaments.
I vote we permaban Zoe from League of Legends, just in general. A champion should never exist for multiple cultural and game balance reasons.
Multiple culture ones.
She's actually 1,000 years old, keeping up every wonderful trope that everyone loves so much.
Don't worry, guys. She looks like a child, but is actually legal.
Legally able.
Imagine
to drive a coining
the term legal lolly.
I believe that was Nick. No, I'm kidding.
It looks like they're gonna try and get some stuff up top lane. But just walk back. No prize.
Looks like we're having some discussions in the chat about whether we're gonna have a best of three or best of five for semifinals and finals. Probably do want the best of five, honestly. It's gonna be hard to schedule it, but it's worth it just to get that proper game.
Yeah, it's gonna be a significant time sink as well.
Yeah, especially since we're now like midway through the school semester.
Oh, let's see. Does he go for it? Nope.
Luxter's over here.
Oh my god.
Oh, I see that you've chosen death by standing within a 3-mile radius of me.
That's true.
Oh no!
The Zac's looking for it.
Did he take it?
He's smelling it. Oh, he's deciding against it. Probably just wanted to
Zac
ward off. Yeah.
Staring ominously.
Counter. He was looking for the counter engage.
He's standing there, menacingly. Oh, this is not good. The team segmentation called positioning on the map is just not great for.
Yeah, 911 doing a fantastic job with these objective control.
Yeah, slowly but surely they're bringing up their gold lead. Now they're up roughly.
Well, oh no!
2K earlier, yeah.
Oh no! Thomas is gonna die.
Is he?
Yeah. You can. Oh, not anymore.
Effects deciding that. Against it.
You gotta shut that. You got the
door. Oh no! He got hit by another bubble.
And Miguel's actually up in the A in the bottom lane.
What the damage?
The way that it goes around the Leona. Absolutely.
That was good. Oh my
Miguel is hiding here, doing his best impression of James Bond.
But no, if you saw that, the bot lane knew exactly where Miguel was. They had the Janna on the sidelines ready to peel the second that Kali decided to go in. It's honestly probably a solid play from 911.
Mm-hmm. 2K gold lead
as
on
well
the side
two dragons.
As well as two dragons. You have the same amount of towers though. But that's just more, it's more prio for the team 901 because they took two mid towers compared to, opposed to the one top one bot tower that the Snake Bolt took.
Thomas is pushing very audaciously and it looks like 911's looking to punish.
Yeah, he's gonna die here.
Way too cocky on his part.
Oh, wait, does he get out?
No, he doesn't.
I think he does.
Nah, Jan is there with the slows.
Oh, come on. That's actually really good. Oh, he gets another W off.
Meanwhile, Larkin is able to get a revenge kill onto the Zoe by using her Enchanted Crystal Arrow.
From Leximity.
That was not a good pick at all.
2-for-1, but yeah. They give 400 gold to Larkin.
Yeah. Like, yeah, they got Thomas, but at what price? You know, they left their carries all alone.
They're sitting on a ward.
They're sitting on a ward.
Oh. Zach looking for the engage.
I don't think this is gonna be a stun.
There's a lot of damage.
Here's the Zach.
That should be given over to Robert. Oh, that's not what you want.
Yeah, you definitely want that given to Larkin.
Larkin, 1000%. He could really use some items right now.
Yeah.
He's already getting strong. Just giving him that extra lead would've been really nice. Miguel's looking for any kind of flank here.
Yeah, 900 gold plus on the Ash would have been really good.
That's true.
And Zoe's looking terrifying with the Ludens and Rabadon stun.
Oh my god.
Had 10 stacks on her Darkseal, but with Larkin shutting her down, she's down to 6.
I mean, at this point, like, you're gonna have to build some form of magic resistance. Larkin's doing that, but that's not enough.
Yeah. He's probably going for the QSS, just trying to get rid of the sleeps if necessary, because, you know, they're absolutely disgusting, but, you know, it's only so much you can do.
Hey, but with that fight, with that dragon fight, the gold is actually very even now, only 100 gold difference, 200 gold difference, though.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
We'll see.
Right. Yeah. Very close.
Let's see if we can actually get anything else here. Oh.
Honestly, both teams probably getting the exact tricks that they wanted, with the segmentation fault getting the cooldown reduction as well as team 911 able to get Mountain and Ocean. They really want that poke.
I feel like if it was the other way around, it'd be better for team 911. I'm pretty sure what they want at this point is ult cooldown reduction.
Ult cooldown actually pretty much helps no one on their team.
I'm pretty sure the Trundle and the Zac do really well with it.
The thing is that Trundle and Zac already have such low cooldowns on their team, on their ults, that they're always have for a team fight. So I actually don't think it benefits them that much. However, it really benefits Ash and Akali to have that lower cooldown reduction.
If I'm like, as a jungler, if I'm the Zac, and not if I'm, because I'm never 625 on Zac, but if I'm on Zac here, I like just the extra resistances from the mountain.
Yeah,
and
you really
the extra
want
regen from the ocean,
yes.
Especially with
it really benefits
so
them.
Chunky. Then if you're 615 on Zac with a mountain drake and an ocean drake, you're laughing it up because like, you're not high.
I think, yeah, both teams really want that soul, though. The move speed just helps them so much in these team fights that they're both looking for.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Miguel trying to contemplate whether it's okay to team fight against Trundle. Just has to slowly poke him out. He's always deviously
just
looking at the sides here.
Farming right now.
Little bit of a calm before the storm situation. We had a lot of action before, right? We got 35 kills in 26 minutes. That's a lot of kills.
Listen, the plays that they have to make in this, in every team fight, it's gotta be the Leona onto the Zoe. That's literally it. She just has to focus that
really
Zoe.
It. But as soon as
make
Zoe,
sure
Zoe's
also
can
the MF.
Blow it up.
Just stun the MF for that ultimate. That's about it.
I don't think it's as useful right now at the moment. Honestly, like, MF ult sure could maybe turn the tide, but it's more than likely just
that. They're going to be spotted out.
On top of the ward,
this might
too.
Be a terrible fight. Who knows? Maybe a little disastrous.
Yeah, no one even TPing over it. Don't know if
that's a TP from Thomas.
Yeah, no,
there's three
days.
And here, yeah, there it is.
Oh my god, there's a team
fight.
Miguel's out though. Larkin has to try to fight, but the issue is Leximity and... Oh, he's able to get the Zhonya's off. And Set's just able to clean up everyone.
They're not focusing the right targets.
Yeah.
He misses. Oh my god, he... The flash. I think Larkin's dead here.
Yeah.
Oh, he should've just kept running. He should've just kept running, but they didn't focus the same target. It's crazy.
Yeah, I mean,
this is crazy.
How are you supposed to focus the same fight when you have three people in a Cataclysm in the Baron Pit as you have a Collie jumping on you, right? I honestly, it's probably just more of a macro decision than a micro one there. I don't think that the team fight.
They got stuck in the pit. That Cataclysm actually closed the mouth of the pit.
Yeah, that was a fantastic play from Robert.
They weren't able to get us. They were just stuck.
The horror, why we're just kind of on there with, like, you know, just the couch, you know?
Yep. They were just chilling. They're like, damn. You guys like coming here? Like, how about you stay here for another like 15 seconds while the while my team just chunks out anyone who's in this little tiny circle?
MF tried to do
that Cataclysm also trap everyone who wasn't in there inside the barrier.
Yes, exactly.
Well.
Yeah,
that's so good.
Yeah, that was a fantastic play from the Horwai. Yeah, honestly,
Nightmare
probably
really
should have not fought that. Like, they really didn't want to try to take the Baron there. They're probably being greedy, just assuming there was no vision, but they didn't spot any of the wards.
They were overlord.
Yeah, they didn't even sweep it at all. Yeah. So, just kind of assumed.
Looking like another fight gearing up in the lower river by Dragon. They want to start stacking these clouds.
Yeah. That cooldown reduction is going to add up real quick.
And all their ultimates are back up again. Let's see if it's going to be a repeat of the last fight.
Exactly.
This Zach just staring them down like, I wish one of them would walk up. He's gearing up for the jump.
Oh no, this is not what you want. Not what you want, Big Stank Mouth.
Yeah.
Oh, and Arlen's jumping onto the... Oh, this looks like the chain CC.
Oh my god. If you saw
beautiful play, beautiful play
that Thomas did with Zach on the R, and there it is.
Yeah, from lifesteal.
Even worse this time.
It's a slaughter.
It's disgusting. No.
Absolutely beautiful team play right there. Arlen knew to switch targeting to the Zoe. He saw Zoe ult in, and I was like, nah. You're not getting this damage onto Lurkin anytime soon.
That's
you guys
right.
Notice it was like five little mini fights that all were starting
very
to go wrong, and then it converged into
Thomas
one
was able to use the ult to get to MF in the back line. That's why Zed is so dangerous to play against.
Especially as Zach. If I don't know if you guys noticed, but when Thomas ulted the Zach, he actually half health the Janna and just punched her to death. Yeah.
It doesn't make sense to do that. I'm thinking Robert as well.
Thomas.
Robert or Thomas, I think.
Alright.
Because both have been making some very clutch plays that have really, like, really turned the tide.
I feel like
game.
In terms of this game,
All right. We'll go back.
Well,
yeah. Wait, not yet. Okay.
All right. Let's see. How will Team 9/11 come back from this? How do you think they can come back from this?
They need to get
it's
some
a counter picks. Comeback. Because, yeah. You know, Team 9/11 was ahead. So it's like, you know.
But if Zoe's able to get a fantastic pick onto the Ashe, then they could probably start swinging these fights. They need to get Miguel, they need to get Ashe. The issue is Ashe and Miguel both are Larkin
top
and
Miguel.
Top
lane fight happening. The ult onto
and that,
these,
that
the troll.
Be a dead Trundle.
Yeah. Oh, the phase rush.
Oh my god. Ooh.
It's not even phase rush. What is that? It's just
place.
I'm pretty sure he stole. Yeah, that
if
Q. Ah,
there you go. Yeah.
No.
That's a that's
the
a
Q
dead
is
goal.
So annoying.
Even,
low
even
cooldown. Plus, it gives him movement speed.
Arlen was coming to try to secure that. Oh, Zach's looking for a fantastic kick here on the side. Akali's not even there. This might be a good fight time for 9/11 to CC initiative.
Yeah, it will be a 3v4 if they initiate in the lane.
My stomach.
It's a fantastic if Zach goes for it.
He looks like he might jump in.
Right. Oh, he does try to go for
he
it.
He missed.
Nothing.
The issue, Zoe didn't realize the sleepy trouble bubble, when it hits the second piece of terrain, it goes over the first one, but not the second. So when she went to the dead tower, it kind of just stopped there instead of hitting Leona.
Really? I thought I just went through everything.
Yep. No, it doesn't. It only hits the first piece of terrain.
Team Seg actually punishes T911 by taking both top and bottom towers.
Yeah.
And holy shit, that's Zach.
I mean, is it really punishing, or is it just Thomas being a cocky motherfucker? He's probably saying, I'm playing Seg, I can do whatever the fuck I want, you know?
Oh no.
Oh no, this is looking like a one shot and a half.
Oh
my goodness.
Ooh.
I don't think Thomas is even being cocky here. He literally needs like three people on him just to take damage.
Zach looking for the engage.
Oh.
Flashes. Burns.
He has a flash for a flash.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, you
that
have.
That is a pretty valuable lane. Flash.
Thomas is now by himself. Is he finally decides to back out?
Oh, Thomas might actually just go for the kill here.
Oh my god, that
can he get anyone?
Oh, he gets someone!
Oh my goodness! No!
Just deletes Donor with him.
Bro, Donor's already had six deaths. He does not want to see that. He had to go Mercurial Scimitar second item in the situation.
And Thomas said, I'm leaving and you're coming with me.
Oh no, that's even... Donor still had flash too. Yeah. He could have got that.
I don't know if you. I mean, that's like 3 point clicks, right? Auto. That's. You're not really flashing much.
Did Donor still have flash? He could have flashed the W.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, to be fair, you don't really expect it either. Like, I would have done
it. Yeah, it was the true damage strip in the middle that he was in, so it kind of just chunks him so much that much more.
Yeah, it's. Yeah, the weird thing is, like, in hindsight, it's so easy to see, like, oh yeah, I should have flashed that. But it's like, there's so much going on,
it's going on at once that you can't
even, like, you're not ready for it.
If you did it by the millisecond, obviously, he probably would have decided that's a bad idea. But, you know, when games are going this fast, it doesn't really matter.
Alright, let's see. Let's see how the, this dragon fight goes.
Yeah, this will be the third Cloud Drake if they get it. That's 30% ultimate CDR on top of normal CDR. For segmentation fault, that's gonna be
a nightmare to deal with.
Every fight's a team fight when you have that low of an ultimate cooldown.
Oh, there it is. Yep. Zoe's locked down. Yep. What do you do?
Okay, Zoe's in a weird position going golden. Imagine getting the cell division and just looking at three people just beat the shit out of you. Oh, they let him get up though. Okay.
That's such a fantastic pick from Larkin right there.
Yeah,
man. Oh, they're sending Larkin a solo drag.
That is not a team fight. That is a massacre.
And once again, no members lost on the side of team segmentation fault. Jesus Christ.
I actually believe Thomas TP'd there and Trumbo was able to cancel the pillow.
That's actually really good.
But here comes Miguel.
Is he gonna take it? Onto the
Pillar is his own teammate there.
With stuff like 70.
Damn. Trundle Arlen just got bonked with the hammer.
He shredded all the resistances that Leona, I guess. Like, Leona doesn't have a lot of health, but she has so much armor and magic resist, but Trundle takes them.
Trundle's like, I see, that's free real estate, give me that shit.
Exactly. Wait, he attacks so fast, though. What's the attack speed?
He has
Wit's End, yeah. I mean,
Triforce gives you an insane amount of attack speed.
It's still not optimal, considering that you do need to, like, clear waves fast, and you do need a TM out for that.
Yeah.
But, hey, it's been working out for him so far.
I don't even think he really cares about wave clear at this point. He's just losing so hard, he needs some wave.
Oh, here comes up.
I mean, like, he does have 6 kills. Like, he's
Larkin.
He's not out of it.
Yeah, there's the...
Oh my god. Absolutely disgusting.
Even when Larkin just walks into like 70's range, he just doesn't care. You know, he didn't even burn a single summer spell.
Super bad. Ashe is just super annoying to play against.
Because of that R?
Because of slow.
Their entire slow kit, dude.
We might have to fight here. This might be the last fight we get for the team.
Again. Maybe trouble bubble.
Oh my god. Okay.
A lot of damage.
Zoe really
that's a lot
out.
Of damage.
The power of Zoe. I saw this deck in half. Oh man. And we're throwing
Oh my god, Thomas.
Oh my goodness.
Thomas.
Jesus.
And Thomas said, you're going to throw me in half? I'll throw your whole team in half.
Thomas lives with the two triumphs that he did from doing that
Dude,
follow the ultimate.
There's too much shit going on. Yeah, with that ultimate, Luxter just was like, yeah, see you later, guys. Just
it
kill me.
So that good. That was a really good engage. And then Thomas
lived.
Pressed R.
He lived again.
R on attack.
It's looking over, boys. This is another series one. By Psych Vault, putting them in the first seed, truly worthy of of that place.
Beautiful stuff from both teams. He's looking like Redfall is going to take this one 2-0.
I do. Who do you think should be player of the game? Yeah, player of the series?
And we are back. Matt, would you like to do the honors?
So, Thomas, it appears you have been selected as the MVP for this
series. Yeah, first, before anything is said, we would like to say it's a very close contest between Thomas and Robert. We were having a really hard time deciding, but in the end, we decided Thomas. So, thank you.
Well,
congrats,
you know, I think my whole team played really well, so yes. I think we're all the MVPs of this series.
Wow. Just here we have heartful plays, heartful words from a team member.
Oh, we do have to comment on your fantastic ultimates that you did gain too.
Thank you.
Robert,
that balance question mark?
Yes. Oh gosh.
Yeah, serious stuff in the top lane with Set. Like,
yeah.
Look away for 1 second and you're just like bringing whatever turret, minion, or champion is there to pound town. Like, it's crazy.
We had some happy moments for sure. There's a few times where I might have gone a little too deep, but
you think?
Overall, I think it was a pretty good game. I think, I don't know. Excited for the playoffs. Feeling positive about my team. Yeah.
We'll just disregard the 2v2 ARAM that you guys did beforehand.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I mean, we lost that. Because I didn't backdoor early enough.
Enabled your team in that the Rs on that set were just really incredible. When everything like looked... When it looked like you were about to die, you just pulled out some miraculous play, able to one-shot the back line. It was crazy.
Yeah, I mean, I think that Set's really good into Misfortune, right? Because I just R their big tank into the Misfortune, and then I use the E to disrupt Misfortune ult. So then, like, that's a lot of their damage gone, and then I can just murder the Misfortune, hopefully, and now I'm in their back line and stuff. So I just think that Set was, like, really good into their comp. Yeah, I mean, I also just think that, like, the split push is really strong. I can draw a lot of aggro away from the rest of my team. So if we do, like, a 4-1 or a 3-1-1, you know, we can really, like, play that split push well. Yeah, I don't know. I just happy with my team. Good games.
Sure.
Well, Thomas, I do have to ask you one thing. What was your reaction when you were 1v1ing Trundle in the top lane and you flashed in place?
I didn't flash in. Wait. Are you talking about when I was under tower?
No, I don't think. It was towards the end.
What?
You guys were like where your tower was, but it was destroyed.
Wait, I flashed in place?
Yeah.
I don't remember this, but I'll
he purged the memory from his mind immediately.
What are you talking about? I only remember immaculate gameplay. I think you guys might have been watching a different game than me.
Oh, yeah, my bad. Spectator issue, I apologize. We'll get that fixed out right quick.
It's okay. I understand.
Just saying now, with the wins and losses chalked up, I can say that segmentation fault is aimed at facing PP in the upper bracket here. So,
all right.
How are you feeling going on against PP here?
I'm feeling pretty good. I have faith in my team. You know, we've had some really good scrim results. I think that, you know, whoever our opponent is, I think we can win. I'm feeling good.
All right. Your support in the chat saying Team Seg more like Team Top Esports just goes to show the amount of.
Apologies. You're actually no. Yeah, my bad. What's it called? You are actually against Seed 4. You're actually against.
Okay. Yeah. Seg. Yeah.
You're against 9-1-1 yet again, making 9-1-1 having played. I think it's like 6 series in a row. Honestly, props to them for the planning and coordination on that. It cannot be easy to do. So how are you feeling going into 9-1-1 the rematch? ready for the semifinals. Or
this series went pretty well, so I'm not super concerned. But you know what? It's playoffs, right? So everyone, I think, is going to like level up, and I think it's going to be a lot of really fun games for sure.
Well, I think the crowd back at home is looking for something spicy. Do you have anything offered or
anything spicy? Like, well, okay, so I'm going to play Jace top. There you go. There's my spicy pick.
I like it. We'll be looking forward to it, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah. Electrocute, might I add, too.
Electrocute, okay.
Electrocute, like Nuguri, yeah.
All right, well, thank you for talking to us, Thomas.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
And good stuff.
All right, so that's going to be
this is a pretty good series, man. Both teams played super well.
It was close, honestly. Both teams really showing a decent amount of teamwork and strategy. You know, I think
that was crazy.
I think it really wasn't like the individual. Yes, the individual players honestly probably weren't like the important thing there. It was really the teamwork, honestly, right? Like that Zach, that Zoe, even the MF was able to put in the effort when the team was able to set her up right. So it really just shows like how much it could carry there.
Both games really were down to the wire.
Like, yeah, I mean, eventually one team fight changes, and
the whole game goes upside down.
Yes, that is true.
Upside down.
That team, that game almost looked doomed until that fantastic Baron fight, you know?
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's going to be the final game of the normal series. Then we got the two semifinals games, which are going to be Segfault versus 911, the rematch that we just had, as well as PP versus Lobster. And then those two winners will go on to play in the final game of Gamer City League Season 1.
Let's get it, boys. It might turn out to be an exciting semis, an exciting end to the entire series.
Yeah. Hopefully a spectacular ending. All right. Any final comments as we head out to this end of the game?
I'm just saying, if I was Larkin in that series, I would report my support for taking all my kills.
All right.
If I were Larkin in this series, I wouldn't be taking my jungler's camps as much.
What would you do if you were Larkin, Andrew?
I would appreciate the fact that I'm getting hard carried.
All right. Well, Larkin, you could have three different people to be except yourself, you know? All right. That's going to be it from us. Thank you.